clarify, identify residential areas to be maintained. Our goal is that business development will grow residential development in a more planned way and ensure that the community continues to be a mixed income community. The process should also ensure that the development includes plans for green spaces within the food belt funded so that the parks and services are maintained in the future. Thinking out of the box, I was just thinking in our meeting, you mentioned it is noted as a food belt. When I was a kid, I was told prior to my being born, there were various trees that resembled fruit. So our goal here is that we also have a mission to bring back the trees. We would like to see lemon trees, orange trees, peach trees, all the things that resemble fruit, and that's some of our plan there. The Fruit Belt also wants to remain a mixed-income community, declaring a moratorium on any further transferring of city-owned lots and property until a residential plan is developed that ensures access to low to moderate-income families. Explore a mandate to have all residential rental developments set aside a portion of those units for low to moderate income tenants. Fund and support initiatives to encourage home ownership by low to moderate income residents. There should be some sense of a plan for even people who have bad credit, that there should be something, an incentive where you can go in and help ensure these people who actually live here, even as rental, to even become one day a owner, as opposed to just revitalizing everything and making it so that we just have people who have good credit. So making sure that the community still stays the same, and yet, at the same time, gentrified in a proper way. Current low to moderate income homeowners should not be forced to relocate due to rising gentrification and resultant property increases. And we just heard our councilman speak heavily on that, and we're supporting that. Explore legal options for keeping property assessment and tax rates at the 2015 level for grandfathered food belt homeowners. And moratorium A, create a mechanism for generational transfer of a tax abatement suppressed rate. B, provide assistance for property owners to stay in the STAR program. Employment and training is another field that we want to identify, demonstrating that the BNMC can impact on the unemployment rate in surrounding communities. Set a goal of reducing the unemployment rate in the Fruit Belt to below 5%. Use a person-centered approach and identify every Fruit Belt resident who is unemployed or underemployed and develop individualized training and employment plans for each of the identified Fruit Belt residents. That was a concern because a lot of the young people in our community want to work, and there's so much around us that's going on with new developments, children's hospital, all the things that are going on, and we need to make sure that if we want to keep it low to moderate, we also employ people in the community so they can stay within this project area. Employment and training. Demonstrate that the BNMC can create or increase the number of minority and women-owned businesses in the Fruit Belt. Our next phase would be the General Community Investment Fund. This relates to funding the community, social service, and cultural agencies within the Fruit Belt as part of investing in the community infrastructure. When I was younger, we had the Neighborhood House, the Moot Center, and as you know, if you look around the neighborhood, even beyond, there was a place called 1490. There is really no real good community center in our neighborhood anymore. We can't have that. We don't want that to happen because it's sad when you can go across Bailey to Clinton Street, they have a community center. You go in other areas, South Buffalo, they have community centers. But the Fruit Belt area, we have nowhere for our seniors to go. And a lot of them would want to go out of their homes, so we need to make sure that community center is invested in. We do have a food center here. We want to invest in that. We also want to broaden the horizon so it fits many more needs. Also part of the General Community Investment Fund, we want to provide funding for residents to be forgiven for outstanding medical bills owed to the BNMC institutions and their affiliate organizations. We have heard of plans in other states and cities where when residents are among gentrification, if they brought all their medical bills together, pulled together as a concert effort, they would be forgiven of these. using so that food bar residents can plan for home ownership and small business development. Another part of the general community investment fund would be to fund a large multi-purpose community center which services all generations from children to seniors, wellness programs, social services, educational, career, and job placement services should be provided. Use a community, no wrong, doer approach. Parking and traffic congestion. There are a lot of concerns in our neighborhood with our residents who have a right to say when they're trying to come home, they should not be forced to park 3 blocks away and or not park at all because the people who are working in the new corridor, the medical corridor, have taken their space and or we've even heard, Councilman, you bet you can hear this, one of our seniors has been basically attacked verbally and even cursed out in many cases because there were trucks in her driveway and or in the area where she was just trying to come in from grocery shopping, and the contractors are coming in cussing out our residents because they feel that they have a right to park where they want to park and park as long as they want to park there. So we're concerned about our seniors having to go out and face these people who come from outside of the neighborhood and are not treating our seniors with the best of respect. So we need something done about the parking and traffic congestions. We insist that any funds derived from such a plan be reinvested directly into the food belt community and a transparent method for tracking and reporting on those revenues be a part of the plan. Lastly, the historic and preservation portion, which deals with establishing a historic preservation task group that identifies all potential historic buildings and landmarks within the food belt. Identify a process for making decisions as to which historic properties have enough significance to be maintained. Provide funding in the form of low-cost loans for community acquisition, repair, upkeep, and support, and fund a video, print, and spoken word museum project that will serve as a legacy of the Fruit Club neighborhood before the story is lost forever. We believe if we go back in our minds when they invested in the Jesse Nash building, they have a corridor at the Michigan Baptist Church, and there is a corridor with footprints. Also, there's history laminated and in showcase. There are so many things in the food belt that we can showcase to the people who don't even know about the food belt. And even if you want to build the food belt, you should know what you're building on. So we're trying to make sure that we know that there's one thing we've been passing out